Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to run this metallic slag sample that one of our customers brought us. This is a pretty cool sample. I'm excited to run it. Currently it's a 3/8 minus. He wants to get it crushed down to about 40 to 70 mesh. We're going to run it through one of our 16 by 12 hammer mills. It's got a 1.2 millimeter screen in it, and we're going to screen the discharge at the end to show you the size ranges we get, and hopefully we can get the most volume in that 40 to 70 mesh size range. So we'll run it, show you the results, and see how it goes. Okay, so here's the results from our hammer mill test. It ran pretty good. It ran a lot faster than I would have thought. But here's the results. We're going to take out, I don't know, a couple, two or three cups and screen it for the customer. And we'll weigh it and send him results that way. And then we'll take the other part of the sample and package it up as is and send it back, and he can do his nose screen analysis. So yeah, I think it went great. We'll screen it here and see what we got. All right, so we took some sample that we crushed. This is 2 kilograms, and I'm gonna screen it through these three screens. I don't have the exact sizes he wants, but we're gonna do a 30, a 50, and a 100, and then we'll take the various fractions and we'll weigh them and see what percentage we got through each size. All right, so here's our screen samples. We screened them into 4 different fractions. The first one here is our 30 mesh plus, and there's about 1 kilogram of that. This next one is 30 to 50 mesh, and there was 400 grams of that one. This is 50 to 100, 325 grams of that. And then this one is our 100 mesh and smaller, and there was 275 grams that fraction. So the screen may have been a little bit too coarse. We got most that was 30 mesh and larger, which was too big for the customer's needs. But there's a couple different strategies we can use for sizing screens, and it will really depend on the finer size, if that's still usable or not. If you want to absolutely minimize the fines, I'd suggest going with a larger screen, screening the discharge, and then running the oversized back in with the raw feed so that you're not grinding any finer than you absolutely have to. If there's a product that you can use the very fine stuff for, then it's okay to run a little bit smaller screen, sacrifice a little bit of fines if you still have a use for them. So that's kind of the strategy that we can use with some of our customers on what they want to do for screen sizing when they're trying to get a bracketed mesh size range of the product. But here's the test with a 1.2 millimeter screen. We can run another test with a 0.8 millimeter screen if they want to go for a little bit finer size range, but that gives them an idea of kind of where it runs with that size screen. So I'm going to send this all back to the customer so he can do his own analysis. And if you guys out there have any samples you want to send us, we would be more than happy to run them through some of our demo equipment here and send you the results. So thanks for watching our video, and we'll see you on the next one.